Morning, everybody. Welcome to the show. Here we are. Town TV's stood in the middle of Popham Airfield, surrounded by microlights and all those sorts of things. But today is the first day of Phamie's challenge, and somebody rang in and said, why doesn't Phamie McDonald go wingwalking? And that's what she's going to do in just a minute. I'll go and get the very nervous Phamie in just a second, but thanks all of you who turned out to watch the Andover Carnival. Sorry it was such a downpour. We were filming, and we put up our huge stage in front of the Guildhall, but it was wet. And in fact, it was more than wet. It was dreadful. But anyway, we're going to bring you some shots of that we took, what we managed to take without Jason drowning. And on with the show, that's all I can say. But where are those crunchies? Where's Phamie McDonald? Is she nervous? I'm going to go and find out. Good morning.
Morning, Al. All I can do is giggle.
Is that nerves?
Yeah.
Nerves.
Whoever rang in and asked me to do this, I hate you.
Wingwalking. Phamie McDonald wingwalking?
Well, if you're a regular watcher of the show, you'll know, and you know, Al, that I'm fascinated with planes and anything that flies. What you don't know is...
I thought you were talking about pilots.
Oh, yes, pilots as well. They come with a job, I'm sure. Yes. Well, what you might not know is I'm absolutely petrified of heights, and I've got a real fear of falling. So this
is... Have you done parachute jumping?
Yes, and I hated every minute of it. It was to try and get over my fear of falling and my fear of heights, but it didn't work. It made it worse.
Never mind.
This challenge has had me on the loo all morning. But I'm going to do it. And I must say, if you're going to ring in with a challenge, if I don't do the challenge, you can give me a forfeit. And can I also just say, if you want to ring in and set one of your friends up for a challenge, we'll storm into their workplace with our cameras, grab them, take them somewhere, and make them do something that they've always wanted to do. So if you've got a challenge for a friend or... You want to challenge me to do something, then give us a call. What's the number?
Andover 390.
390.
Or Salisbury 555.
222.
Or you can send us a fax on Andover 390.
391.
That's it. Dead right. Very good. So, anyway, Phamie will do the dangerous ones. We won't make you do the dangerous, really dangerous ones.
No, I'm properly insured.
Yeah.
And I am trained. I will be trained.
Somebody wants you to climb the north face of the Eiger, I think.
With a carnation up my nose. Thanks then, everyone.
Anyway, here we go. On with the show. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Bye, Phamie. It's lovely to have met you.
Yes, it's
bye. You can stand there on your own. Bye.
Bye.
Phamie, you're going to be up there in a minute.
I feel fine. I'm fine. Where's the toilet?
That's twice you mentioned the toilet. Never mind, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
They look splendid.
They look great. If you look in the reflection on this propeller, this wonderful Pratt & Whitney engine, you'll see Jason on camera. And he is actually going to go up and do some air-to-air photography. So this is going to be really good. You're going to be able to see Phamie screaming her head off from very close. And I don't know, about 5,000 feet, but should be quite good fun. You don't mind going up, do you, Jason?
No, not at all.
Not at all. What a heroes we are at Town TV. So anyway, we're just waiting for Phamie to come back. Kitted up and a bit of a lesson on how to wing walk, and off she goes. So we'll see you in just a second.
Right, so this is the guy that's going to be piloting me. What's your name?
Mike Dentith.
Mike Dentith, the pilot.
That's right.
Looking after me very well. So I'm in the process of being kitted up.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to be shown all around the plane and the harness and how all that works.
Right.
What kind of things will I be facing up there?
Well, yeah, hopefully today, because it's not very warm, one of the things you won't be facing is lots of bugs hitting you.
Yes, I'm worried about flies in my eyes.
You don't have to worry about that, because they only come out in the warm weather. So if you smile, which you will, because you won't be able to help it, the thing to do is to grit your teeth so you don't actually eat any.
Unless, do I pick them all out when I get down? Like, pick all the flies out of my teeth?
Yes, you'll need to do that. But no, so there shouldn't be too many today, so that's all right. And we're going to give you a rather smart pair of skydiving goggles, so you shouldn't get anything in your eye.
Right, well, you're going to show me around the plane. Would you like to just take me over and show me what's what? This is a splendid plane.
It's a lovely aircraft. It's a Boeing Stearman, which is a 1940s American training airplane. It's the sort of American equivalent to the English Tiger Moth, right. The famous Tiger Moth. And this was built in serious number. It was on order from the American government. They ended up building 12,000 of these aeroplanes for training pilots, particularly American all forces pilots. And in fact, there were some British pilots that were also trained in Canada and America that then subsequently went on to fly Spitfires.
Right. Has there been much adaptation done to this plane to make it...
Yeah, some big changes. The basic airframe is exactly the same as it was. It came from the factory with a 220 horsepower Continental engine, and these have got double that. They've got 450 horsepower, because obviously when you're up there and that rig's up there, that's like a huge windbreak. So the more power we have to get you off the ground, the better.
I was told we were at the Wallop International Air Show filming you flying there, and I was told the wingwalkers have to be quite small.
Ideally, yeah. The smaller they are, the less of a windbreak they are, and much easier for us to fly. So we're not looking for somebody who's particularly large to go up there. So the smaller you are, the better. And you're a good size.
That's good.
You're a great size.
I'm glad about that. Right, well, while you prepare the plane for me to fly, I'm going to go and speak to Vic. Now, he is the guy who is the boss of the team, and I'd like to talk to him about how long he's been going and what kind of things this crunchy flying circus does. Vic, hi, morning.
Hi there, morning to you.
You're the boss of this team, aren't you?
Yep.
You are. So how long has this team been up and running, and who started it?
Well, this is our seventh season.
Right.
With Cadbury's Crunchy, and I started it 7 years ago.
You started it yourself?
Yeah.
And it's a very small team, isn't it? There's only four or five of you, isn't there?
Well, it's a small team here, but actually back at base to support these aircraft, we do a lot of flying. We did 91 shows last year. We've got two full-time engineers and two full-time PR girls, because it's the PR side that matters as far as our sponsors are concerned. So. Right. You just see us here with the two aeroplanes, but actually back at base there's quite a big support that's going on.
So have you ever wing walked yourself?
No.
So you're going to be piloting the cameras plane.
Yes.
This is Jason.
Hi, Jason.
And this is the man who's going to be piloting you. So that's fabulous. I can't wait. I've always wanted to do this. Yeah, I saw you.
You must be mad.
I must be absolutely crazy, but we'll see when I come down. I saw you in a magazine, not you personally, but I saw the team in a magazine years ago, and I always thought I'd love to do that, and now it's my dream come true, and I'm really happy. Thank you ever so much for taking me today.
Well, we're delighted that you're going to have a flight with us, and I'm sure you'll enjoy it.
Yes, so will I. One more time to the toilet, and then off we go. If you were watching Middle Wallop International Air Show, you'll remember Helen Tempest. She's the lovely lady who came off the wing walk and I interviewed and said, Helen, can I have a go? And here I am.
It's happening, isn't it? Well done.
I didn't expect it to happen so fast. So what are you going to do now?
Well, I've got a very sexy hat for you and some even lovelier gloves. And I'm going to kick you up in this. And then Tania is going to attach you to the top of the aeroplane.
Right. Now, how long have you been doing this?
Oh, a long time.
Long time.
Yes, I've been with Vic since the inception of the team, and then I used to fly with my dad on Tiger Moths before that. So, last 15...
So you're used to being up in the air then?
Yes, it's my second home up there. I get confused if I'm not allowed to fly.
Right, let's get kitted up in this, this caboodle
it
then.
It protects your ears mainly from the wind. So that goes over there like that.
And is it true I might get flies in my mouth?
Oh, definitely, yes, if it's that kind of day. But
do you smile when you're up there?
Love it. Well, Tony and I are usually shouting at each other. I mean, not that we can hear, but we're usually screaming and shouting at each other. Right, there you go.
core.
Pixie, Phamie.
I look like a pixie, he says.
And the goggles are tinted to protect your eyes from the sun.
Lovely.
So we think of everything here. Now, pop the gloves on when you get up there,
right?
Because so that you can grip onto everything. It's like climbing up a giant stepladder. That's the fun bit, getting you up there.
Is there anything I shouldn't do?
Okay, well...
I can't hear actually what you're saying to me because I've got these things over my ears.
What you need to do is Tania will strap you in, and there's a locking pin up on the wing. So that means that you are attached totally to the top wing. You can't get out by accident. Mm-hmm. And we will then, when you land, we will come and get you out, which means that you're nice and safely secured whilst the propeller's running, which is the important thing. We don't want you wandering off into running propellers.
No, I don't think I want to.
That's dangerous, that is. So we attach you to the aeroplane and you are safe until you get down, and we will come and rescue you. Now, the main thing is that Mike can see you all the time. He gets a wonderful view of your bottom, which makes the thrill of his day. And so he can see you at all times. He will shout at you before you take off, "Are you all right?" And you go, "Yes." And then he can see your thumbs up. If you're not happy at any time, it doesn't matter whether you're on the ground or in the air, at any time you're not happy, both arms out, thumbs down, and then he can see you and he'll come and land and we'll have a chat about maybe what's wrong.
Right.
But hopefully you'll be just laughing your head off and giggling to your cameraman.
And swallowing flies.
Yes, and he'll be flying in the other aeroplane in the front seat, so you'll be looking at him and waving and maybe kicking a leg in the air or whatever you want to. So all you have to remember is that once you're in, you're very safe and secure. You don't need to hold on. You can just wave and enjoy yourself.
Brilliant. Well, let's get in this plane then before I change my mind.
Well, first thing to remember is this is a fabric aeroplane.
Right.
Okay, so if you put your foot on there, it's going to go through the fabric. So you need to only step on the places marked out and the places that I'll show you.
Yeah.
Okay, so first thing is put your hand on there, foot up here, and pull yourself up.
Yeah.
So that you're standing on the black bit marked out.
Oh, that pig.
Come on.
I'm dignified, aren't I?
Right, I think what I'll do is if I go up first and show you where I'm standing.
Right.
And then you can follow me up. So the first thing is there's handles here and here.
Yep.
For you to use should you need them. You put your foot on the back of the seat there. Like that.
Yep.
And hold on to this strut here. Stand up on there and put your heel on there. But you can step on any of that semicircle, but not on the glass. If you step on the glass, you'll crack it. Okay. And you kneel with one knee on there. Put your arm through so that you're holding on. And your other arm on the wire.
Yeah.
Bring your other knee up so you're kneeling. Then you bring this leg round until it's on the black.
Yep.
And your other leg up. And there you go.
So there we are. What do you think, viewers? Do you think she's going to enjoy this? Would you enjoy doing that? I'm sure you would, but we're going to let you know in a minute. Just about to take off. Having a final lesson, so I shall stand back because they're going to start the engines in a minute. So see you in a minute.
Right, well, the aircraft are moving out in formation now, and Phamie is going to go off in the lead crunchy. They're coming down the runway now. Incredible sight, the waving. Phamie's waving. Incredible sight.
do this for a living. You're so lucky. The most fantastic experience of my whole life. I can't believe you do this for a living.
It's brilliant, isn't it?
Oh, it's just one, the most adrenaline-inducing thing. I'd like to say thank you so much to Vic. Thank you, Vic.
Pleasure.
Real. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Tania. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Helen.
You're welcome.
All
right.
It's all been wonderful. You've looked after me really well. Where can people see you next? Where will you be?
We will be at Yeovilton, actually, which is not very far away, this coming Saturday.
Right.
So we will be there.
Ah, the ship. This won't get on that show, will it? We won't be too late to know about that.
We're at Fairford, which is a
international
huge show.
Yeah, tattoo.
Yes.
Excellent. On TV last night. So.
Brilliant. Well, thank you so, so much. If you ever need a wing walker again, I'd pack my job in and come follow you wherever you are.
I remember you said that.
Absolutely.
Thanks a lot. That was brilliant. Thank you.
Well, before we leave Popham Airfield, I'd like to introduce you to Dick Richardson, the airfield manager here. Morning, Dick.
Morning.
A wonderful day here with the Crunchies flying in.
Very nice, very nice. Well, the lads have been here before with the aeroplanes. We're delighted to see them. Yeah, they add a bit of spice to the airfield.
Tell the viewers who don't know, where is Popham Airfield?
It's on the A303. It's sort of between Basingstoke and Andover.
It's a lovely location. What does it cost to fly here?
Well, I should point out that all the aircraft here are privately owned. It's a private airfield and a recreational facility. Not much happens during the week. It's a weekend. The place comes alive at weekends.
You have lots of clubs flying in, guest appearances by aircraft and different things, is that right?
All sorts. Yeah. Every month we have a fly-in of one sort or another. This weekend, for example, we've got a host of foreigners coming over from the continent and Sweden with their aeroplanes. Yeah, it's great fun, great fun.
And can you have flying lessons from here?
No, you can't. We're an unlicensed aerodrome, so flying training cannot take place other than the microlighting. You can do that on an unlicensed airfield.
But people who can fly can buy a share of an aircraft and fly from here?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely, yeah. We've got about 100 aircraft based here now.
Really?
Absolutely, yeah.
Will you do maintenance here as well?
Just a little bit, just over here, a small maintenance setup, yeah.
Absolutely fantastic. So what's for the future? You're not going to put a runway in on?
No. We're going to stay exactly the way we are. We're a very popular little grass airfield. We want to keep it that way.
Okay, splendid. Thanks for letting us come in with the Crunchies this morning.
It's been our pleasure. Okay, thanks.
Smashing. Thanks very much.